I've grown up my whole life treasured and excited about the baptism of the Holy Spirit, praying in the Spirit, saw the value of it in my personal life, but didn't really understand some of the benefits and the strategic nature of praying in the Spirit to its fullest. It was my dad's generation, kind of, and I heard him in the morning when he would get up in the morning, and I just, man, it was awesome. It was modeled for me. Now, you're talking about, I would say the majority of the people in our churches, they probably don't have that experience in their life that they grew up where they heard. Now, many of us may, but not everybody. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They don't even know what it's like to pray in the Spirit in the way where the Spirit's praying through you, and there's understanding, and there's revelation, and there's regular communication with God. Let me tell you something. It will light people up. Yeah. When God gives them a scripture, and they have a need, and they're looking at the scripture, and it says if the scripture jumps off the page as if God just wrote that for you right now, like he's talking to you, That's when you go, this is fun. This is awesome. This is no ball and chain. This is for real. God's real. His Spirit is in me. Okay, like this. Now, one of the things that has to happen, though, is it has to be modeled and experienced and exciting and personal, that we're not telling stories of our own that are about back when I was in 1975. I remember back when God really did something. I mean, it's got to be, I remember Tuesday this week.
Yeah.
Let me tell you what happened Friday.
Yeah.
You see, it's got to be something that's norm all the time. When God spoke to us this last week in staff, it's got to be that type of thought. That what we should be doing, 1 Peter 4:11, is that every time we're speaking as if we're speaking the very word of God. I know, I just was with God. God's telling me even right now what to say, like this. Okay, an authority, that's how the authority comes. Now, this has got to be a natural, supernatural flow, where it isn't something that is like only the super Christians can do. It seems like a lot of times, there's two or three people in our church who've got the corner of the market of spiritual things. They're the ones who always, if there's any quiet time, you know they're going to do tongues. Because if they're cornering the market, then what they're doing is with some kind of, whether they know it or not, it's been trained or modeled, or it's a spiritual thing in the church, they're basically announcing to everyone else, I got it, you don't need to do it. But that's not the model. All of us are prophet, priests, and kings. All of us have been called by God to flow in this way. Now, one of the things that's got to be done is that how we model. Here's what I think in a lot of times that even in my life growing up, in board meetings and staff meetings and times where we would be meeting together, is that we had an agenda and we opened the agenda with what?
Prayer.
With prayer. And it would usually be, Brother John, would you just open us in prayer and just ask God to give us his Spirit and his leading, okay? It'd be like this. Oh God, we thank you for this time coming. It would be something like this, okay, right? Mm-hmm. What you would be more like, is there benefit to it? Yes, but there's more of a token. Let's ask God to come on in and help us for a minute. God, will you bless us as we do your business? Right? What I've shifted in my mind is prayer isn't what starts an agenda. Prayer is the agenda. I'm talking board meeting agenda. The agenda is the heart of God, the mind of God, the Spirit of God leading us. I'm talking about a staff meeting now. We have an hour and a half long staff meeting every Monday. The first 45 minutes, we pray in the Spirit and ask God, what is he saying to us? That's what I'm talking about. Like, there's a shift in thinking that we're saying, this isn't led by us. Guess who I am? I'm not the leader of the church. You say, well, I thought you were the pastor. Who else is the leader? He is. I'm the lead follower. I follow first. And so it's in this mindset that I just wanted to bring a thought to you here about teaching of how to pray in the Spirit. And here's the thing I think we've got to move towards. It's not, hey, come on, brothers and sisters, we're assembly of God. This is what distinguishes us from everybody else. We pray in tongues. If we didn't pray in tongues, we'd be Baptists. Well, you know what? That doesn't mean nothing to me about having a distinctive that makes it distinctive as a movement and holds a movement together versus other people. I want to know the benefits of why I need to pray in tongues besides it gives us something as a fellowship. The distinction is I have the power and the Spirit of God inside of me, not to make me more powerful than another denomination, but to make me more powerful than the person I'd be without it.
Come on. Yeah.
I need this and I want to flow in this, and God has given it to us as a tool to flow in for revelation. And I'm not just talking, is it beneficial in the service? Yeah, we'll talk about that later at another time, I'm sure. But what I'm talking about here is the incredible benefit of praying in the Spirit and with understanding in our own personal lives and in our prayer meetings and in our staff meetings and in our board meetings and in the people of our church understanding Ephesians 6:18 saying pray in the Spirit on all occasions is all kind of prayer and supplication. That's part of the warfare armor of God. Don't think the armor of God just stops with the sword of the Spirit. It says, and with praying in the Spirit on all occasions. It's one of your weapons, man.
Amen.
The Spirit of God prays through you.